is the matchup for WCW. Sold out pay-per-view, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
It was another one of Flair's rulings. You know, our pay-per-view events are usually headlined by WCW, NWO. Sold out. No longer the case. This is a World Championship Wrestling pay-per-view event. And Ric Flair and his son, David, making his pro wrestling debut, will go into the ring against a pair of second-generation performers in Kurt Hennig and Barry Windham.
Tradition represented in that contest and sold out 1 week from tomorrow night on pay-per-view. Bull Payne in the ring, fresh off his placing absolutely dead last in the Brad Pitt look-alike contest, will face Big Bobby Duncum Jr., another second-generation competitor here in WCW.
And we have been awfully impressed with Bobby Duncum Jr. since his debut in World Championship Wrestling a couple of months ago. Big former football player, 6'5", 275-plus pounds, had quite a few battles with Chris Jericho as of late. Tonight on WCW, Saturday night, to face Bull Payne.
And the big cowboy is going to try and rope this bull on the superstation.
You know, I keep thinking about Sold Out and that headline main event, the tag team match with Rick and David Flair against Kurt Hennig and Barry Windham. And I keep going back to Charlotte, North Carolina, and the role that Barry Windham played in the attack on Ric Flair's family, the suplexes on David Flair. I just wonder, do you think David Flair is ready for professional wrestling? Do you think he's ready for Kurt Hennig and Barry Windham?
If you go strictly by genetics, there's not a man more ready in this country to make his debut than the son of the 13-time former World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. And David Flair now has an issue also after what Barry Windham did to David Flair in Charlotte, North Carolina. That was disgusting. Eric Bischoff kissing Beth Flair right on the lip, right at ringside, and David Flair left laying while Brian Adams had Reed Flair up shoulder high. He was kicking and screaming like any other 10-year-old would be. I can't wait for Sold Out 1 week from tomorrow night to see David Flair get his hands on Barry Windham.
December 10, 1972.
What about? You're older than that.
December 10, 1972 was the first day that the Nature Boy Ric Flair ever set foot in a professional wrestling ring.
Whoa!
And David Flair will make his pro wrestling debut on January the 17th at Sold Out. In terms of David Flair being ready, I go back to what the enforcer, Arn Anderson, said. He said, I know that this kid knows what he's doing, and the time is right, and that's good enough for me.
26 years ago, Ric Flair made his debut. David Flair is only 22 years old. Ric Flair's career is older than his tag team partner at Sold Out, but you know what? I would not bet against the 13-time former World Heavyweight Champion. I don't care if he's been wrestling 126 years.
Well, if you think back, he actually, when the match went down, he asked to have a handicap match,
yeah,
one against two, against both Barry Windham and Kurt Hennig. But now David Flair is a part of that match, making his pro wrestling debut at Sold Out.
Well, it was only because of Kurt Hennig that Ric Flair came up on the short end at Starcade. Hang on, Duncum! Cradled up Bull Payne, got the two count. Flair can thank Kurt Hennig for losing that contest against Eric Bischoff at Starcade.
Yeah, realistically, he has to thank him because of what went down the next night, as we see Bull Payne go for a very nonchalant cover. Because it was the next night, the night after Starcade, on Monday Nitro, the return match between Ric Flair and Eric Bischoff, where Flair wrested control of WCW away from Bischoff.
And you know what? Even the coffee's better around here.
Tell you what, the water's better, I know that.
Duncum, lateral press, hooks the leg, gets the two count.
I mean, that's something that we're joking about, but just think when you walk through the offices of World Championship Wrestling, Scott, this past Monday at the Georgia Dome, the looks on the faces of all the employees of WCW. Duncum in the corner gets another two count. It was a great accomplishment for Ric Flair, and I think all the employees of WCW are proud to have him in charge.
From the guys that empty the trash cans all the way up to the top of the rung of WCW, everyone loves having a new boss, especially Ric Flair. Duncum gets the three count on Bull Payne. Bobby Duncum Jr., second generation competitor, on his way up here in WCW.
Well, we talked about Bobby Duncum Jr. impressing us. He continues to impress as he scores the win here on WCW Saturday night.